Big welcome to Advancing AI 2024. It is so great to be here in San Francisco with all of you, so many press, analysts, customers, partners, and lots of developers today. And welcome to everyone who's joining us online from around the world. It's been an incredibly busy year for AMD with lots of launches across new products in our PC and in our embedded portfolio. But today is a special day. Today is all about data center and AI. We have a lot of exciting news and products, and so let's go ahead and get started. So let's talk a little bit about AI. Actually, I think we're going to talk a lot about AI today, if that's all right with you guys. Over the next decade, AI will enable so many new experiences that will make computing an even more essential part of our lives. If you think about it, AI can help save lives by accelerating medical discoveries. It can revolutionize research. It can create smarter and more efficient cities. It can enable much more resilient supply chains, and it can really enhance productivity across virtually every single industry. And our goal at AMD is to make AMD the end-to-end AI leader. You know, when I talk to business leaders today, everyone's focused on, number one, how do I use AI as fast as possible? But number two, how do we maximize the impact and ROI for their AI initiatives? Now, when we think about AI, it really is about choosing the right compute for the right application. So when you look at all of these compute needs, we certainly have the best portfolio in the industry to address end-to-end AI. So let's start first with the core of the data center computing, the CPU. I've spent a lot of time with CIOs recently, and what everyone's thinking about is, how do I modernize the data center? They want a CPU with leadership performance, efficiency, and TCO. With Turin, that is exactly what we've delivered. Turin is fantastic. It features up to 150 billion transistors across 17 chiplets, scales up to 192 cores and 384 threads. And one of the things that's very special about 5th Gen EPYC is we actually thought about it from the architectural standpoint in terms of how do we build the industry's broadest portfolio of CPUs that both covers all of the new cloud workloads as well as all of the important enterprise workloads. Yeah. Here we have Turin. In the last 10 months, we've been laser-focused on ensuring our customers get up and running as fast as possible with maximum performance right out of the box. And to do that, we've had to significantly drive improvements and continuous improvements across our ROCm software stack. We've integrated new features, we've optimized new libraries, we've enabled new frameworks, and we've significantly expanded the third-party ecosystem that supports ROCm. As a result, if you look today at MI300X performance, we have more than doubled our inferencing performance and significantly improved our training performance on the most popular models. Today, over 1 million models run seamlessly out of the box on Instinct. Today, I'm very excited to launch MI325X, our next generation Instinct accelerator with leadership generative AI performance. MI325 again leads the industry with 256 gigabytes of ultra-fast HBM3E memory and 6 terabytes per second of bandwidth. Now, when you look at the overall platform with 8 GPUs, we deliver significantly more AI compute and memory as well. The 8 GPU version features 2 terabytes of HBM3E memory and 48 terabytes per second of aggregate memory bandwidth, enabling our customers to run more models as well as larger models on a single MI325 server.
AMD believes we have cracked the code on the problem of delivering high-performance, evolving networking chips that can evolve at the speed of AI. Today, I'm excited to announce Salina 400, the third-generation DPU for SmartNICs and smart infrastructure, and Polara 400, our first AI NIC product.
We've launched a tremendous number of new products today that extend our portfolio of leadership across data center, AI, and PC solutions. You can count on all of us at AMD to continue to push the envelope on high-performance computing and AI, and we are just getting started.